Hey there, everyone. Beautiful day here in northern Minnesota on the Red Lake Nation. Today, we're going to show you how to skin a beaver. Alrighty, here we go. First thing you want to do, you want to take your beaver, lay him on his back. First thing you want to do, grab the back leg. Cut around the back foot, right where the tendon meets the foot. Same thing with the front legs. And once you've cut around all 4 feet, just go ahead and twist the back legs off. Same thing with the front legs, give it a twist. And I like to center my beaver. And you want to start at the vent, and if you want, you can draw a line up the center. Your finger up. Now once you've drawn your line from the vent up to the chin, start at the vent, poke your knife in there. You want to follow that line all the way up to the chin, as straight as it can be. And you want to go from the inside out so you don't cut any of the fur. Just follow that all the way up. Through the chin. Once you got that cut made, you go down to the tail. Same thing, right up the middle from the tail. Up to the vent. When you get to this place, and you want to cut around the vent. On both sides. You just want to work your way around. It's okay if you make deep cuts. Better making the deep cuts than damaging the fur. Pop the back leg through, follow the back leg up to the towards the back. Just work your way back towards the back. Same thing on this side, once you get to the back leg. I like to just pop my knife through, cut around the leg bone a little bit. Once you may have a little hole there, you can pop the back leg through. And you want to cut up as close as you can to the leg. It's okay if there's a little meat on there. We're only doing a rough cut. You can always flesh it off. Same thing as you did with the back legs. Make a little cut. Pop the leg through. There we go. There's no need to hurry, just take your time. It's not a race. The beaver, they can be used for many things. You can eat them. I've heard they have really, really tasty meat. I've never eaten one myself, but this year might be my year to try it. The beaver casters. It can be used as an attractant. The beaver tail, you can render that down, make an oil. That could be used as an attractant. Some people use the casters for medicine. I think they even use the casters for some perfumes. After you get it skinned towards the back side, flip it over, follow your cut, go around the tail. People use the tail, the leathery part, for crafts. I've seen wallets made out of them. You can use the hides for many different things. Some people like to save the skulls. Do like a European mount. That looks kind of cool. All predators love beaver. The meat's oily, fatty. So all animals will eat beaver. Yeah, people aren't the only ones that think the meat is delicious. You just want to slowly work your way around. I usually start at the tail, but I like to get a little further up on the back. And as you can see, there's a lot of meat on the hide, but like I said, that's what the fleshing knife is for. Now from the tail, all you want to do is work your way up towards the head. No, it's not a race. You don't want to be sewing up little holes here and there. But if you do cut into the hide, nick the hide, you can sew it. I always like to angle my blade toward the meat. That way, if you do happen to slip, the knife slips, it'll just cut into the meat. You won't cut the hide. Just take your time. There's no hurry. I just like to hold my hide upward towards the head, trying to pull on it as I cut. It'll kind of show you where you need to cut as you pull. Sure, buddy. Yep. Oh, you want to smoke some beaver meat? Okay, buddy. Sounds good.
Love you, Dad.
Love you, too.
Love you, Dad.
Love you too, baby. I just keep working your way up like this here, and you can see, give it a little pull, you don't see exactly where you need to cut. You don't need to cut hard. Let your knife do all the work. Just pull it across there. Getting up towards the shoulders. As you can see, we're coming along pretty well. That's a nice coat. Probably a blanket size. And when you come to the cartilage on the ears, just cut inward. Towards the skull. All right, now we're at the back of the head. I'm to the ear here. There's the cartilage. Just cut right into the. I like to cut as deep as I can. There, through the cartilage. There's the ear hole. Just slowly work your way up towards the nose. can feel the cartilage here. I can feel the other ear. I cut downward through the ear. Get to the eye holes, just cut deep, right up against the skull. I like to. Follow the nose, follow the skull, all the way to the nose. So the nose, you want to put the nose on there, so you cut in and down slowly, right to the teeth. There you have it. Nice beaver fur. See the ears, eye holes, the nose. Good size hide. Like I said, it'd be probably a blanket size. There's a couple different ways you can skin beaver. This is the way I skin beaver. If anybody, any of you have any tips or comments, feel free to leave them. If you like the video, hit the like button. If you love the outdoors, subscribe to our channel. We trap, hunt, fish. And I appreciate all the support. Thanks for watching.